responding. And Joe, I want to start with you on this one because you have such a unique take to this. What we saw from President Trump this week in those visits to Dayton and to El Paso, mm-hmm. and then the fallout since then, a lot of it coming with this photo, and we're just going to put it up for folks, of this is two-month-old Paul, both of his parents. I mean, the story of his parents losing their lives. His mother was found laying on top of him. She tried to protect him. Her husband, who his family later found out on Sunday, had died. Her husband, Andre, this little boy's father, died afterwards at the hospital. This boy's life, so tough. He was brought back by his family. So we want to point that out. His family was happy to be there. But the fact that this is the picture that the First Lady tweeted out, and we're seeing the president with the thumbs up sign, to say that there is some tone deafness here, it's not the first time. It's not new. It's not unexpected. But it doesn't make it okay, Joe. And I know that you have been in this situation where you have been with a president who has gone to comfort families after a shooting tragedy. I mean, just put it in perspective for us. What we're looking at, and then what you've experienced.
Yeah, it's really an unprecedented situation, and I think we've become numb to the phenomena of Donald Trump. But it's worth exploring just for a second. You know, I worked for President Clinton. We went through Columbine. We went through a mass shooting in Oregon, and one of the hardest things I ever had to do, and it was nothing compared to what the president had to do. Was the families of the victims, those who had died, would gather in one case a school cafeteria, in another case a school gym, and they'd sit together with their families. And the president went family to family, heard their stories, and put his arms around them and comforted them and did what a president is supposed to do. Mm-hmm. And this president, you know, there's a big debate about whether he's capable of it or just doesn't want to do it. Who cares? You know, it's his job. You know, the video that they released out of Dayton was sickening to me. It looked like a campaign ad, and it was all about how Donald Trump was well received, not what Donald Trump brought to Dayton or what Donald Trump brought to El Paso. I don't think he met with any of the families of the victims who died. It is a terribly hard job to do. And I can tell you this. I got on Air Force One with President Clinton after these school shootings, and we didn't put the TV on and complain about politicians, and we didn't have Twitter, but we didn't go out and hold a press conference about how the president was being mistreated. The president was gutted. He had just gone through the absolute worst part of the job, and it stayed with him for days and weeks and months, and probably is still with him. So while we're, you know, we've seen it all from Trump, we really should understand that this is a fundamental failure of Donald Trump as president of the United States.
All right.
Not only of the president, because we've already established that he does not possess an empathy gene. This is not the first time that he's been this calloused and unaware and used, you know, things to feed his own ego, putting that in front of any kind of unity or leadership. He just isn't capable. It's not who he is. But people that support him seem to be okay with that. They make excuses for it. Or you have someone like Tucker Carlson who goes on air at Fox News and tries to diminish the problem of white supremacy that's on the rise in this country and tell people that it's a hoax and it's a lie. Where, you know, I wrote a piece for CNN.com that's up now about this, and I use the example actually of the family of the young boy, the young infant that the picture is involved in. I use the example of his sister because there's other kids involved besides that 2-month-old. His sister, Skylin, who's 5 years old, asked her family after she found out that both her parents had been gunned down, is he going to come and shoot me next? I mean, these are the kinds of heartbreaking stories that we're facing when with these kinds of massacres. And the president of the United States is standing there in a photo with a thumbs up. I mean, these people owe they owe everyone that's ever been a victim of these kinds of shootings an apology, because they disrespect the memory of the people who've lost their lives by being so flippant about it, making campaign videos, complaining about crowd sizes. It's disgraceful. And the people who justify this, they're just as bad. Because I remember, because I was part of those Republican circles, when Republicans went after President Obama for not effectively calling out radical Islam, for going to play golf after a journalist had been beheaded, and he made comments about it, yet the president of the United States is yucking it up at his private golf club the evening after a massacre happened in El Paso. but no one seems to have a problem with it. I mean, this really is about what the soul of America is at stake, whether this is what the American people want as leadership. Because that fundamental question that Joe Biden keeps pushing, I think, is a good one, because that's what we need to ask ourselves. In times like this, in times of crisis, is this the kind of leadership that we want? And I would think the answer is no.
Right. You know, I think it's a truism that when we have any type of tragedy, it tends to bring out the best in people and the worst in people. And we saw some of the best in people in the response of the community of El Paso, where my family is all from. The people responding with compassion for the victims and love and support and just trying to grapple with this trauma and move forward. And we see the worst in the president. And it does not bring me pleasure to say that, because he is the leader of this nation. We see the worst in this president, who can't show anything other than his own narcissism and cannot stay away from this type of petty infighting for one day, and remove himself from the arguments and the attacks. So that to me is profoundly sad.